address to see Bishop Michael Campbell, parish bishop of Lancaster, and that we've been very happy to have you here this morning for this great solemnity of Christ the King, and to admit Brother Joseph Murphy into candidacy. So, we welcome you here. We're grateful for your presence. Thank you for being here with us to celebrate this momentous occasion. Welcome to all who have joined us today.
visions during the night continued. I saw one like a son of man coming from the clouds of heaven. When he reached the ancient one and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. on your own, or have others told you about me? Pilate answered, I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests handed you over to me. What have you done? Jesus answered, My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom did belong to this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not here. So Pilate said to him, Then you are a king. Jesus answered, You say I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
My dear people and dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the God has enabled me to live in the peace of Christ the King. Apparently, in that gospel, his patron is not a normal one, it is from another world. My kingdom is not of this world. That's a wonderful scene portrayed for us in the Gospel of John. We have the eternal Son of God, a prisoner, sitting before Pontius Pilate, the ruler of the land and the representative of the almighty Roman Empire. What a remarkable scene. Of course, it's truth itself embodied in the Son of God, sitting before a very positive type. For this is our Lord, for this I have come into the world. And everyone who hears the truth listens to me. Christ came to bring us the truth from God. Says elsewhere in John's Gospel, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Not the powers of this world, nor the kings of this world can give, but only Christ himself can give. The way to God, the way to his Father. So today we acknowledge that once more. We bow down before Christ, acknowledging as the one who said to us, He became a king, paradoxically, to say the least, with his death on the cross. He reigned from the cross and Campbell campaign through his hardship, suffering, death, and of course, his resurrection. So that campaignship is indeed different. Entirely different from what we understand by kingship. The apocalypse also tells us that by belonging to Christ, we are a royal family, or kings and queens, if you like, through our dignity in baptism and in our following of Christ. Part of the incarnation that Christ shares whatever he has with us. He is a king, he shares that with you and I. We are kings and queens, clearly not in the understanding of this world. So today is a remarkable feast, really, one that has to be properly understood. Christ came to bring us the truth. There are many versions of truth abounding today, but here's this definitive truth, which has come from God, our Father, and in which we have been anointed through our baptism and through the sacraments. We are anointed by the Holy Spirit. In the biblical understanding, the true king is one who ensured that all of his subjects, the poor and the least particularly, were well looked after and cared for. There was to be no preference, no privilege. In his days, justice was flourished, peace were told to the moon fades. He cares for each and for all of us. I think it was St. Augustine who said that Christ, God, cares for all as he cares for each, and he cares for each as he cares for all. So today, briefly, by being here, in my presence as a bishop, your priest, your parish priest, you are affirming your loyalty and your commitment to Christ, the King. In a moment or two, Brother Joseph will be invited to candidacy before us here at the church. And that is a public acknowledgement on his part. Christ comes first in his life. We're delighted to be part of it, and we support him with our prayers. Christ the King, whoever is on the side of truth, hears my voice. So we reaffirm that truth today as we celebrate this Mass, this Christmas. We pray in a particular way for Brother Joseph and for the community here, that truth of Christ always take the first place in all that they do. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, our brother who stands here today in the presence of the church is being recommended both to us and to you for admission among the candidates for holy orders. Christ has given this command: ask the Lord of the harvest to send laborers into his harvest. Aware of the Lord's concern for his flock and recognizing the needs of the church, our brother, therefore, considers himself ready to respond generously to the Lord's call. Trusting the Lord in whom he places the hope of faithfully pursuing his vocation, he says At the same time, it is to us he entrusts the task of making inquiry concerning the suitability of the candidates. Only after they have been duly tested shall we call them, and by the particular seal of the Holy Spirit ordain them for the ministry of God and the Church. For by their sacred ordination they will receive the mandate to continue personally the saving work of Christ which he accomplished on earth. And so when the time comes for them to be joined to our ministry, they will serve the Church and build up the Christian communities to which they are sent by proclaiming the word and celebrating the sacraments. So now, dear brother, we speak to you, who have already begun your formation. Through this formation, you will learn each day to live according to the way of the gospel, and to be strengthened in faith, hope, and charity. By practicing these virtues, you will grow in the spirit of prayer and in zeal for winning all people for Christ. Compelled by the love of Christ and strengthened by the inner working of the Holy Spirit, you have come to the point of making a public declaration of your desire to devote yourself to the service of God and others in the holy orders. We welcome this desire with joy. From this day forward, we must cultivate your vocation in greater depth. To that end, make particular use of whatever means may be offered to you for your help and support by the ecclesial community entrusted with this task. Trusting in the Lord, we will all assist you with our charity and our prayers. Therefore, when you are called by name, come forward and declare your intention before the Church assembled here.
Most Reverend Father, for the Oratory of St. Philip Neri in the Archdiocese of Washington, Brother Joseph Tyson Murphy.
My dear son, the pastors and teachers charged with your formation and those who affirm that they know you have given a good report of you, which we fully trust. In response to the Lord's call, do you resolve to complete your preparation so that in due course you are made ready to undertake ministry in the Church through holy orders?
I do.
Do you resolve to form your mind and heart in such a way that you will be able faithfully to serve Christ the Lord and his body, the Church?
I do.
The Church receives your resolve with joy. May God, who has begun a good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only God, the Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead,
and his kingdom will have no end.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life,
who proceeds
from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who is spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
I confess
one baptism for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to our Lord and God that he may be pleased to pour out the grace of his blessing upon this his servant, who desires to devote himself to the ministry of the Church.
That the Holy Church of God may proclaim to the people of our time the saving truth of the Gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Brother Joseph may cling more closely to Christ and be able to stand as his witnesses before all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That he be able to bear the burdens of others and listen always to the voice of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That he be made a minister of the Church, who will strengthen his brothers and sisters in faith by word and example, and gather them to participate in the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord send laborers into his harvest and fill them with the gifts of the Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all people may come to the fullness of justice and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all our suffering brothers and sisters who share in the passion of Christ may be in freedom and healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let all the faithful departed be gathered into the fullness of God's kingdom with all the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, the giver of every good gift, hear and answer our prayers, and pour out your Spirit upon Brother Joseph, whom you have called to serve you. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to me the immensity of your majesty and the eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so the angels and archangels, the thrones and minions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory to pardon we again.
Thank you. Before us, the sign of faith and Thank you.
Send your